Good morning and welcome back to Summit Sunrise. I am joined by Duncan from Loveland. Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, we were just saying how much snow you guys have gotten.
Yeah, you know, this week has been really good for us. After weeks of beautiful but dry weather.
Right.
Finally some...
I knew that was going to happen. It always does. This is Colorado. It never fails.
It always does. And it's perfect for powder hounds and spring breakers alike.
For sure.
We had over a foot of snow midweek this week. And with the forecast looking like the skies are going to clear up again for this weekend and become warm and sunny, it's going to be a great spring skiing weekend at Loveland.
It is. I like the pattern that we're on. The snow, then sunshine, the snow, then sunshine. And my guess is that we're going to have some powder days in April because we typically do up here.
Loveland is our second, or April is our second snowiest month up at Loveland.
Mm-hmm,
so
mm-hmm.
You're right. We're bound to get some great powder days in between these beautiful, warm, sunny days.
Without fail, this is true. And then also, there's some powder with the powder skiing too. You guys actually, this weekend is perfect, the weather for the scavenger hunt you guys have going on.
Yep.
It's like perfect. I don't think you could order better weather.
No, it's lining up to be a great weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And you're referring to is the New Belgium, they're calling it the Mountain Adventure this year.
Okay.
But it is the scavenger hunt and it's been going on for almost a decade now.
It's a long time.
It is one of our most popular events, and it is just so much fun. Basically, what you do is meet at Loveland Saturday morning by 9 a.m. so you can get your clue sheet on time.
Oh, and okay.
Yeah, you have to be...
Clue sheet and your thinking cap. Bring
yep,
that, too.
Exactly.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It's only a $10 person donation to the Alliance for Sustainable Colorado.
Just $10,
Just
huh?
$10.
Okay.
You know, get yourself a group of at least four or up to four people.
Okay.
And, you know, make sure you wear costumes. There's bonus points for best costumes and whatnot.
Mm.
And as you can see from the pictures, people go all out. So, and then spend the day trying to find the chicken on the hill, get your picture taken with Sasquatch, solve the riddles, the clues, beat someone at a game of Connect Four.
That is totally cool.
It's a great way to spend a day on the hill with your friends or family. It's all ages. Of course, there is a great after party with delicious New Belgium beer.
Mm-hmm.
For the adults only, of course.
Of course.
But kids are more than welcome to participate. It's just a fun, zany activity. Great way to spend it on the hill.
Oh, it sounds like a fun. It sounds like a fun activity, whether with your friends or even if you're with your family. I remember doing things like that with my parents, and it was always so much fun.
Exactly.
And also, too, your giant Easter egg hunt, which is actually like when I say giant, like. I mean, like, giant Easter egg.
Well, it's funny. Just talking to Copper, they have a giant Easter egg hunt.
Right. And, like, as many, like, in quantity.
In
they
quantity.
Have 65,000. But you guys are doing... This is a new take. This is cool.
In terms of size of eggs and prizes. So, basically, there are a set number of giant Easter eggs hidden on the hill with amazing prizes, such as skis, snowboards, season passes, tons of great gear in these giant eggs. And they're hidden all over the mountain. That'll be on Easter Sunday next weekend.
That is so cool. I feel like next week you should bring in, like, you should bring in an egg to show me how big these things are because the prizes in them are fantastic. And what you were saying is so cool is that when you open it up, there's a card in it, and you have to take that to find out what your prize is.
Yeah, when you find your egg, you're not necessarily what you got. You have to bring
right.
it down to
you
the
to,
office.
You have to find out.
And
oh, the
claim
egg,
your prize.
That would kill me. I would need to know, like, right away. My patience is about this big, so.
Oh, and it's even more fun when people aren't expecting, they don't know about the Easter egg hunt, and they find something. And bring it in, and they win a brand new Never Summer snowboard.
Right.
They are pretty excited, so.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome,
so,
not gonna lie.
That's on Easter Sunday the 5th,
okay.
Loveland's giant Easter egg hunt. So.
And for more information on all of this, because you guys have a lot of live entertainment on the weekends and lots of things happening for springtime here.
Oh, spring break in Colorado is the best, and it's even better at Loveland. Live music every weekend,
okay.
Children's entertainment down at the Valley area.
Oh, perfect.
And, of course, scavenger hunt and giant Easter egg hunt. So for more information, visit us at skiloveland.com.
Okay.
Don't forget, we have the Ridge Cat running every Wednesday through Sunday, and that's completely free.
Mm-hmm.
Free snow cat rides along the Continental Divide.
I've been telling everyone that they really need to get up and do that. Now's a great time.
Exactly. The snow is just perfect for
and
it.
And the views don't suck either.
Nope, not at all.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So skiloveland.com. Check out our Facebook page as well. Tons of great information there. And we're looking forward to a great weekend at Loveland.
Excellent. Well, if you're partaking in the scavenger hunt, good luck. because I think that sounds like a ton of fun, and you guys should all definitely sign up for that. So thank you so much for joining me and telling me about all things Loveland. It's always so fun over there. And we have more Summit Sunrise to come. Don't go anywhere.